Here we are in After Effects. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a zoom in and zoom out transition. So let's begin with the zoom in transition first. Here I have two videos on a timeline, and in order to add a transition, we need to add an adjustment layer first. Let's go up to Layer, New Adjustment Layer. Make sure it is above both videos. Then let's open Effects and Presets, search for Transform. Add the transform to the adjustment layer. Then let's move the time indicator to the point of the cut between the videos and move 5 frames to the left. Then head over to the Effect Controls panel under Transform. Let's create a keyframe for scale by clicking on the stopwatch at 100. Go back to the point of the cut, and since we're zooming in, we need to set scale to 300 to zoom into the video. Then press U on the keyboard, and let's make the adjustment layer the same length as the distance between the keyframes. Let's move the start of the adjustment layer to the first keyframe, and the end of the adjustment layer to the second keyframe. If you don't see the end of the adjustment layer, you can move the time indicator to the second keyframe, select the adjustment layer, go up to Edit, Split Layer, or press Ctrl-Shift-D as the shortcut, and then delete the rest. Also make sure, while you're still here, you uncheck Use Composition Shutter Angle, and set it to 360 to add motion blur to the transition. Now let's select the adjustment layer, go up to Edit Duplicate, or press Ctrl D as the shortcut. Then move this adjustment layer forward in time so it starts with our second video. Then press U on the keyboard while it's selected to reveal the keyframes. And we're going to move the time indicator to the first keyframe of the second adjustment layer and set scale to 25. Since we need to continue the motion that we created in the first adjustment layer, we're zooming in. We need to continue zooming in over here. Let's move the time indicator to the second keyframe of the second adjustment layer and set scale back to 100. After that, let's drag and select all four of the keyframes, right-click any of them, keyframe assistant, easy ease, or you can press F9 as the shortcut. Then while the keyframes are selected, let's open the graph editor. And here we're going to use speed graph, right-click, make sure speed graph is selected. Drag and select the first point to see the yellow handle. Drag the first yellow handle all the way to the right, second one to the right. Then select the middle point, drag the third yellow handle to the left, and the fourth one all the way to the left. This is how the graph should look. Now exit the graph editor, and before we preview, make sure you move the first keyframe of the second adjustment layer 1 frame to the left and the second keyframe of the first adjustment layer 1 frame to the right to get a smoother transition. And also we have all this blank space that we need to fill, and for this we can use motion tile, search for motion tile, add it to the second adjustment layer, that is where we have the blank space. And make sure in Effect Controls it comes before Transform so it works properly. Then set Output Width to 400. And output height to 350. Also check mirror edges to get another transition. And now if we preview this from the beginning, we have a zoom in transition. And now let's move on to the second example, the zoom out transition. So we have the same exact videos over here. Let's go up to your layer, new adjustment layer, then search for transform again, add it to the adjustment layer, move to the point of the cut and 5 frames to the left. Create a keyframe for scale at 100, go back to the point of the cut, and here, since we're zooming out, we need to decrease the scale to 25, and press U on a keyboard, make the adjustment layer the same length as the distance between the keyframes, then select it, Control D to duplicate it, and move it forward in time so it starts with the second video, select it, press U on a keyboard, and let's adjust the first keyframe of the second adjustment layer, set scale to 300 since we need to continue the zoom out motion, then go to the end keyframe of the second adjustment layer, set scale back to 100, and while we're still here, make sure you uncheck Use Composition Shutter Angle for the first adjustment layer, set it to 360, and also for the second adjustment layer, uncheck 360 to add motion blur. Then drag and select the keyframes, press F9 to easy ease them, go into the graph editor, and let's create the same exact graph. So this one goes to the right, this one right, select the middle point, this one goes to the left, and this one goes to the left. So the same kind of graph, but it's upside down this time. Then exit the graph editor, and before we preview, we have the blank space that we need to fill. And for this, we can again use motion tile, and add motion tile to the first adjustment layer this time, since that is where we have the blank space. Place it above transform, output width 400, output height 350, check mirror edges. Now let's move the second keyframe of the first adjustment layer 1 frame forward, and the first keyframe of the second adjustment layer 1 frame to the left. And here we have the zoom out transition ready to go. So here it is, very smooth. And that's how you create zoom in and zoom out transitions in After Effects without any plugins. Thank you for watching.